Brinson, our roadie extraordinaire, has just called up a girlfriend of his here in Washington. He made arrangements for him and two other people to go stay at her house. So him and Brent and Dennis are going to go stay there, and we're kind of stuck. So we're going to get the bus towed and try to find a place to get it fixed. We don't really have anywhere to stay, so I guess we'll call our friends over at the Discord house. And that's where Minor Threat, one of the biggest bands out on the East Coast, lives. They're kind of responsible for starting the straight edge movement, which is pretty much an anti-drug, anti-drink, anti-one-night stand movement that's gained a lot of notoriety around the country. And I think it's a pretty neat thing. I don't think they agree with all of it, but I respect them for it.
People in our age group used to sit around, get fucked up, throw bottles, you know, drive fast and you know, whatever, and, you know, be ruckus and be rowdy and all that shit. And that was 5 years ago, and when I became a punk, my main fight was against the people that were around me, the kids, my friends, the people I saw, and I said, God, I don't want to be like these people, man, because I didn't feel like I fit in at all with them.
Yeah, so we found
an alternative.
Yeah, we found an alternative, and now a lot of people, what would punks be doing now? Sitting around, getting fucked up, and being rowdy. That's what, I don't want to be that. You know, I want to beat that, man, and I know that we can. The Merchants of Georgetown, won nothing more than punks to do. From the smash out windows, spray paint on the walls, drink in the streets, and beat up people. And the reason we fucked them so good is that we went to Georgetown and we're honest as shit. We never steal. We fucking go to the stores, we pay our money, we're polite, thank you very much. You know, we're just totally nice. And best of all, we're fucking got our head shaved. We're like punk rockers, and we're totally going against what they want. I've always been straight, you know, the most part. I've never smoked dope in my life, you know, and then I realized, because I was sort of an observer of all my friends and how fucked up they're getting and how stupid they're acting, I kind of, a deep, deep hate for it came in. Straight edge is not like, it's not a set of rules. Straight edge is just, it's not saying I'm better. It's basically saying I got my head straight. I've got my shit together, and that's why I've got the advantage on you. As far as people emulating me, or not emulating, but just because I don't drink or because they feel like it's a set of rules, I could just try to say to myself, well, at least it's not a bad set of rules. At least it's like not just like, at least I'm not saying, you know, shoot heroin.
We're playing Baltimore, and with all the excitement, all the action on stage, or, you know, the sling got busted, a wire got pulled, a microphone got broken, I don't know, but the PA people freaked out, took all the microphones back, just started tearing the whole set down, shut the whole PA down, which left us without a PA. But actually, I think it made the show, like, real great, because without the PA, everyone sang, and I didn't have the microphone, sort of like the big barrier thing was gone, the microphone was gone. In most cases, maybe that would stop the show, but lucky for us, most of the kids know our songs. It actually made the show a whole lot better, because we're all singing, and just like, it was like one great, like, chorus.